talk about an integrative unit. How important is it to train the body in a tensegrity eccentrical way, and why is it important?
So that's another great question. Let me clarify what tensegrity and centrical means for people who may not understand. So let's think of the body like a bungee cord, because I'm from New Zealand, so we like to talk, you know, everyone bungee jumps in New Zealand. Gravity pulls the body down, right? And ground reaction forces are like impact, which are the forces coming back up through the body. So imagine your body's like a bungee cord, and gravity's your body jumping off the bridge, right? So that's force of gravity pulling you down, which is stretching the bungee cord. So now you're getting tension or tensegrity in the bungee cord, which is like your body, right? Uh-huh. And then ground reaction forces are coming back up through the body, because with a bungee cord, your bungee cord is fixed to the bridge, right? So you've only really got the gravity pulling down to add tension to the bungee cord. The thing with the body is ground reaction forces come back up. So it's like the bridge is being taken higher and higher up into, up into the sky. So now you've got both ends of the bungee cord being pulled away from each other. Gravity pulling it down, ground reaction forces pulling it higher and higher and higher. That's what adds tension or tensegrity to the system, and in an eccentric or a lengthening fashion.
Yeah.
So with a bungee cord, if you can do that correctly, like you can pull either end of the bungee cord correctly without fray, you know, if, let's say there was a fray in the bungee cord or someone had cut the bungee cord a little bit, then you're going to get stressed that bungee cord when you add tension to it, right?
Yeah.
But if the bungee cord's healthy, that tension you're putting into the bungee cord is what gives it structural support and power to be able to then move, right, and make the person come flying back up.
Yeah.
So that's like your body. Gravity pulls the bungee cord down, ground reaction forces pulls it back up, you get tension in the system like the bungee cord, and now that stored energy in your system is what creates power to drive you and move you and perform well in golf and tennis or whatever sports you are. The only problem is if you're out of alignment or you've got dysfunction in muscles and soft tissues, your bungee cord isn't going to load or stretch well. So tensegrity and eccentric training is very, very important, but I think first and foremost, you better make sure that your bungee cord or your body is working well and in alignment. Otherwise, that stress to the system of loading it eccentrically is going to show up because it's a lot of tension through the system.
Yeah.
So you need to know how to make sure that the body is working correctly as you add these eccentric movements to it and try to get tension or tensegrity throughout the system, both, you know, locally, like at a certain area, like a foot or an ankle or a hip or a spine, or as a global system as the whole body with, you know, full functional movements.
Yeah. Okay. And how important is core stability in this story, and how should we train it?
That's a huge question. I could probably talk for hours on that.